Hi everyone. Today we will be discussing SAP Global Rollout, and within that we will find out the key differentiators between the first rollout, where you create a standardization template, versus the further rollouts. Now let us take a deep dive into it. Now the key separators for the first rollout project. So basically, when we are rolling out a template in the first country or first company code, what typically is done is you just don't understand the requirements of that particular country or company code. You invite SMEs or process SMEs from across the globe, or might be key regions from your organization. Let's say you have FI finance SMEs, you have sales SMEs or purchasing SMEs, and if you are into producing some materials, then might be production planning SMEs. All these process SMEs you will invite and at one place, so that they come together and discuss the various requirements, business processes across the organization. Now within this also, you should invite the SMEs from key differentiating regions. Let's say if your revenue or profit margins are high from North America and Europe, then inputs from these SMEs matters a lot. Let's say if your production happens in Asia Pacific region, then inputs from those SMEs matters a lot compared to other regions. So depending on your region and the percentage of impact which it has on your processes, those SMEs you will bring together for brainstorming, so that they come up together to identify the common processes, or might be the best processes which you can deliver to the organization at global level, and then you come up with the template. So what happens in this case is you get best from all the worlds, rather than just going for the first country where you are going to roll it out. So this is a key differentiator between the first country and the further subsequent rollouts. Now once you have identified standard processes across the globe, you prepare a standard template for these processes, and that's what is called as standardization. It is a term which is used in SAP Global Rollout processes projects. And you also because you have identified, brought in these SMEs together, you also call out or identify areas where you will need customizations in various countries or further rollout. So the areas where in customization will be needed will also be called out, and they will also be listed in this standard template. So that is what this first global rollout will also focus on, rather than just implementing the ERP in that particular region or a country or a company code. Now the subsequent rollouts across the globe, what will happen is the activate preparation and explore phase will concentrate more on the delta differentiators and for that particular country, which will be country specific requirements. So the first template, the first rollout will focus on standardizing the template, and that rollout's preparation and explore phase will be more extended, because you're not just implementing it for that particular country or company code, but you're standardizing the template. But going ahead for rollout 2, 3, 4 or whatever it is, you will focus more on the delta differentiators, and you will go through the list of I already identified customizations in the standard template, and areas where any other further customization is needed will be called out and implemented. And there might be some country-specific requirement or processes which are not part of this global template or the standard template. those also will be identified and implemented because they are specific to a country and it has nothing to do with the global template because it's not there in the global template. So that is what happens when you have a subsequent rollout. The next topic which we will be discussing is timelines and its advantages as far as SAP global rollout is concerned. So thanks and keep on watching my videos. Bye.